In this exercise, we'll present some basic Rhinoceros features and functions. Open Rhinoceros 64-bit version by double-clicking its icon on the desktop. Display the new panel on the startup dialog. Select the large object meter template from the list. In this guide, we'll be specifying the size, distance, and other parameters, so keep in mind that your units are set in meters. If you experience issues later on with elements not appearing in ARCHICAD, the reason could well be that you used the small value specified in this tutorial, while your units remained set in millimeters, for example. Change the units as needed by either selecting your units on the startup dialog screen or selecting a new template. We will be using meters for units. If the Rhino startup screen did not display or faded away too soon, please select the new option from the File menu, where you may also specify the necessary units. Open the Rhino hands-on tutorial.3dm file from the File menu to begin this chapter of the training. This Rhino file is part of the downloaded training package. How do we navigate in Rhino? Use the right mouse button to orbit. Press Shift plus the right mouse button to pan. Please note that the shape of the cursor changes to reflect the navigation mode. It's important to know the kind of elements used by Rhino, because when we reference elements from Rhino to Grasshopper, we must use the right element containers. Observe the different element types shown in this tutorial file. There are 2D and 3D elements. The 2D elements are points, lines, polylines, and curves. Points are the most basic 2D elements. They're based on Cartesian coordinates x, y, z. Lines are connections between two points. Polylines are a sequence of lines with a curve degree of 1. Curves are polylines with a high curve degree. Both polylines and curves can be either open or closed. How do you change the curve degree? Select the polyline above the polyline's text simply by clicking it with the mouse. Type rebuild into the command line. When you press Enter, the rebuild dialog appears. And here you can change the curve degree. Please enter 3 for the degree value. Observe how the polyline becomes a curve by changing the value of the curve degree. Take a look at the 3D elements. 3D elements groups include surfaces, polysurfaces, extrusion objects, and meshes. Surfaces in Rhino are like a sketchy rubber sheet. Their topology is rectangular. They can be modified with control points. You can turn the control points on or off with this button, located on the left side of the window. Surfaces can be open or closed, trimmed, and untrimmed. Turn the control points on by clicking its icon located on the left side of the window as shown on the screen. A left click will turn the point on, while right clicking will turn them off. The points can be moved individually once they are turned on. Notice that if you turn the control points on for a trimmed surface, the original control points can be seen for the whole surface regardless of the trimming. In wireframe view, you can see a set of crossing curves, isocurves, along the V, and another set along the U direction. They help you to visualize the surface. If a surface is selected, you may change the isocurve density in the Properties menu located on the right side of the window. The Properties menu can be reached from the Panels menu item. Changing the isocurve density in the Properties panel on the right side does not change the number of control points. Click on a surface and change its isocurve density by typing a value higher than 1 into the density field. We'll enter 4 in this example. Pan in the file to see the poly surfaces. Polysurfaces are a series of connected joined surfaces. If they enclose a volume, they are solid polysurfaces. Solid polysurfaces must be watertight, otherwise they are open polysurfaces. Sometimes a single surface can be solid, for example, a sphere or a torus. Extrusion objects are like polysurfaces, but they use less memory. Although Rhino is primarily a NURBS modeling software, it also includes mesh modeling tools. We are not going to use the mesh modeling tools in this tutorial because of their limited importance in Grasshopper. In Grasshopper, we're going to work mostly with surfaces, so let's get acquainted with the Surface tool in Rhino. Choose the Surface Tools palette from the toolbar at the top. Notice that this changes the setup tools on the left side of your Rhino window. Pan towards the left of the 3D elements to the letter E in the text Extrude. You can extrude 2D elements with the Extrude tool. You can use the Extrude button from the setup tools, or type Extrude into the command line. Choose the letter E above the Extrude text by clicking it with the cursor. Select the Extrude command from the toolbar and pull to extrude. Finally, click to finish the extrusion. Undo the command. Let's see how to change the default direction of the extrusion. Select the polyline, then click the Extrude button. You can define the extrusion with various shortcuts. D for direction, B for both sides, S for solid, L for delete input, T for two boundary, P for split at tangents, and A for set base point. You can also select these options from the command line. Now select direction in the command line or type D and press enter. Now you have to define the base point for direction, then the second direction point, and finally the extrusion distance. You can issue these commands numerically by typing a number in the command line, or graphically by simply clicking on the screen. Pan towards the right to the text Revolve. You can revolve elements with the Revolve button. When you click on the Revolve button, it prompts you to select the curves to revolve. Select the curve shown on the screen, then press Enter. Now define the start and the end of the axis. To easily set the axis, turn on OSnap at the bottom of your window if it was not yet on. Set the start and revolution angle by typing the number, or simply by clicking the beginning and end point of the revolution. Complete the Revolve command. You may also define a revolution angle numerically. The four-point curve is the simplest surface. You only need to define four points. The program creates a surface connected to these points. Pan towards an empty area. Select the corresponding tool from the left. Define four points to create a surface as shown on the screen. This tool defines a surface from 2, 3, or 4 edged curves. Pan towards the text 4 edge curves. Select the surface from 2, 3, or 4 edge curves icon on the left. Click the four curves above the text as shown on the screen. Notice that the created surface is divided up into separate surfaces. The created surface is not one single NURBS surface, but a polysurface. This is indicated by bold black curves. What could be the reason for this? The reason is that all edges of a NURBS surface must have the same curve degree, which is not true for these curves. Let's undo the last operation. As mentioned earlier, you can change the curve degree by typing rebuild in the command line. Select all four curves, as shown on the screen, and change the curve degrees to 4 by using rebuild. Now all four curves have the same curve degree values. Let's create the surface again using the same steps as above. Click the Surface from 2, 3, or 4 Edge Curves icon, and then click on the 4 Edge Curves again. Notice that this time the result is a NURBS surface. Pan to the right towards the simple loft text. Curves are lofted in the order you select them. But it's also important where you select them. Select the loft icon on the left, or type loft in the command line. Select the two lines to loft by clicking their opposite endpoints. Notice that the created surface is twisted. To correct the twist, you can align the curves in the Loft Options dialog box that pops up during the creation of the loft. Click the Align Curves button in the Loft Options dialog. Drag one endpoint of the curve towards the other, and notice how the resulted surface changes. The Loft Options dialog box includes several style options. Normal, Loose, and Tight define how the loft fits the curves. Straight sections will create separate sections between the curves. Developable means that the loft can be created from a flat sheet for manufacturing purposes. Don't modify the style option this time, but lower the number of control points to 5 in the dialog. Pan towards the right, towards the multiple curve loft text. Select the corresponding command icon on the left. Let's start to create a multiple curve loft by selecting all four curves. Select all four curves on the same end. If necessary, you may use the Align Curves option later in the Loft Options dialog to modify the results as shown on the screen. You may also select a different style for the multiple curve loft. Pan towards the right, towards the Sweep 1 text. Please notice that there are two different commands to sweep. You may use Sweep 1 or Sweep 2 rails. You can also sweep one or more profile curves. Let's take a look at the Sweeping 1 rail option. We are going to sweep one profile curve along one rail. Click on the Sweep 1 rail icon in the generic toolbox on the left. Rhino will prompt you to select the rail first, so please select the curve. Then continue by selecting the prompted cross-section curves, so select the single cross-section. When you're finished defining the curves, please press Enter. After pressing Enter, the Sweep One Rail Options dialog appears. Here you have more options to edit the surface. Let's continue and see what happens when we have one rail, but two profile curves. Select the Sweep One Rail command again. After you set the rail, select the two cross sections. Similarly to the loft command, it matters where you select the cross section curves. If you select the two curves on their opposite sides, the small arrows will point in different directions. You can drag the seam points at this point to adjust, since they are pointing in different directions. Define the direction in which the cross-section is moved along the rail. Do this by dragging the small arrow shown on the cross-section curve. This will be more important when we work with more than one profile curve. Press Enter once the arrows point in the same direction. Pan to the right towards the Sweep 2 text. Now we're going to see how the Sweep 2 Rails tool works. Select the Sweep 2 Rails command and select the two rails as shown on the screen. Make sure to select the curves at their right edges. As you are prompted to select the cross sections, select the cross sections at the right end of the cross section curves. Press Enter to see the resulting surface. The Sweep Two Rail Options dialog appears, offering various cross-section curve options. Notice the Add Slash button. Use this to set the direction of the curves that define the cross-section. You can adjust the outcome of the operation by shifting the cross-sections to another direction. Congratulations! You've completed the basic rhinoceros training.